Okay, so key number three in the five keys that George Leonard presents to us in his book Mastery is the courage of a master is measured by his or her willingness to surrender. Now, a lot of people have this connotation that surrender is actually weakness. It actually is strength, more so than weakness. To surrender is not, you know, let's put up the white flag and let's give up or whatever. A lot of people think of it in an odd manner. And there's some books that I would like to touch on down the road. One of them is Michael Singer's book, The Surrender Experiment, which is a phenomenal, phenomenal read. He has a couple books out, The Untethered Soul is another one of them. Those are two incredibly good books that I would like to touch on as a podcast down the road, is one of our podcasts. So you will hear me doing something on one of those. But surrender is key. So the early stages of a new learning of any language, not excluding visual languages, invokes the spirit of the fool. Now, what does that mean, the spirit of the fool? It is inevitable that you will feel clumsy and awkward when you start a new skill building, and this is a good sign. It means it's hard, and it means that you know, you're going out there and you're giving it a shot, right? You're going surfing, you're falling over, you're sucking in a lot of water, you're floundering around looking like a fool and a fish out of water, so to speak, no pun intended. So you will learn to take literal and figurative pratfalls depending on what you are learning. So if you're learning how to snowboard, you're gonna be all over the place. You're gonna be on your butt 3/4 of the time, sore wrists, sore butt, sore everything. Just because you're going to be falling all the time, endlessly, until you learn the moves, you learn the fluidity, you learn to relax, you learn to give into the process. I mean, all those kind of good things. So, after all, learning any new significant skill involves certain indignities, right? It makes you look foolish. So as we get a little older, we get embarrassed by looking foolish. We are afraid to go out and look like an idiot. We're afraid to put ourselves in a position where we look weak, or we look, especially as a man, I mean, men have a very hard time with this, because, you know, a lot of times you're kind of brought up to be, you know, this don't cry, don't show emotion, don't do this, don't do that. And you know, you're going and learning how to dance, for example. My wife was is getting back into dance, and she's a really good dancer, and she wants me to go learn salsa with her or something, or you know, something like that. And it's pretty terrifying, you know? I mean, I'm gonna look really stupid, you know? I'm gonna go out and I'm gonna struggle, and I'm an okay dancer, but it's gonna be hard. I'm not good with choreography. I have a dyslexia problem, so I have a hard time seeing things backwards. Like, if I'm seeing a move, it's very difficult for me to pick up on the move, because I can't really see it properly. So there's certain things that I'm just gonna have to be okay with. You know, I'm gonna have to go in and look stupid and be okay with it, and shirk it off. And if I wanna get good at it, I'll have to do the same thing I did with any other mastery course. I'll just have to start on the process of diligent practice, you know, over a long period of time. And you know, I'll be on plateau and all those other good things. So, and then there is the endless repetition, the drudgery, the basic moves practice over and over. Who but a fool would embark on a musical career in the full knowledge that he or she might end up repeating all the major and minor scales perhaps 100,000 times each? Wow. The essence of boredom is to be found in the obsessive search for novelty. Satisfaction lies in the mindful repetition, the discovery of endless richness in the subtle variations on a familiar theme. That is so nicely put. So the essence of boredom is to be found in the obsessive search for novelty, right? Not substance, novelty. So satisfaction lies in the mindful repetition. Okay, so getting in the process, loving that mindful repetition, that is the reward. That is what you're after right there. It's not boring. It's inspiring, because there's subtlety in that. So he says, the discovery of endless richness in the subtle variations on familiar themes. How many times can you draw an eye in 3/4 and still make it fun? You can draw it from Frazetta. You could draw it from Loomis. You could draw it from Bouguereau. You could draw it from Vanderpoel. You could draw it from a life. You could draw it from casts. You could draw it out of your head. You could draw it from a sculpture that you sculpted. You could do all kinds of things. How can we find the subtlety in studying the eye? We're just taking this as a hypothetical situation. It could be the nose, lips, ears, head, anatomy of the shoulder, the body, the quads, the torso. Could be perspective, could be composition. God, I could go on for hours. But the point being is, how do we find ways to study these things over and over again, repetitiously, without getting boring? They're only boring if we see them as a novelty. If we see the depth within and the subtlety within these concepts, there's endless opportunity to learn and to have fun learning them. But you have to get in there and be willing to find that connection with that object, that thing. And sometimes the hardest thing to learn are going to be things that you're just not generally interested in. For example, I love anatomy. I love people. I love muscles. I love the way they work and operate and the dynamics of them, the engineering of them, the biomechanical aspect of them. So I study them a lot. But when it comes to tech, trains, planes, automobiles, I don't have the same interest, quite frankly. So, but I have to somehow find the substance in those things that I don't like as much. And that's going to be more challenging, right? Because they will look kind of like a novelty to me and I will get bored with them. So the key then is, how do I get good at the things I don't like, because I need to, because they're going to help me in the long run in my other areas? Well, that is an art, and that's where you're going to have to give up and relinquish some of your childlike tendencies, some of your, oh, poor me, I have to study this, or, oh, God, you know, I'm bored, and it's, I don't like studying perspective. Suck it up, put on your big boy pants, and try to find the substance and subtlety underneath the boredom, right, you know, the novelty. So cultivate the mind and heart of a beginner at every stage along the way. For the master, surrender means there are no experts. There are only learners. So that's an excellent little way to end that particular section. So again, that was not a long one. That was quite, I mean, it was probably longer in the book, but I kind of broke it down into its essence. So surrender, the willingness to surrender to what is, to surrender to what must be, the practicing, the relentless practicing, the plateau. These are things we need to surrender to. They're not going to change because we want them to change. We can quit. There's no problem there. You can quit anything. But to stick with things, you have to relinquish control. You have to say, this is the way that this is. I need to acknowledge that, learn from it, make it fun, and continue forward. Not fight against it, not push against it, not revolt against it. See it as a inspirational part of your life that's pushing you forward to higher and greater, you know, things. I mean, we can't always, you know, have our cake and eat it too. It can't always be marshmallows and unicorns, you know. It's going to be tough at times, and that's okay. It's good. That's what's going to build the character. That's going to build the patience, the practice, the perseverance, the persistence, the four P's that we talked about earlier. That's what's going to help put those in place. So the next key that we're going to talk about, key number four, is intentionality, to be intentional. Okay, so that one's coming up next.